fucking bits. Make sure you stay in the trenches. Help keep our channel ad-free by becoming a supporter over on Patreon and also scoring yourself some free miniature swag in the process. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. Check out our site, spikybits.com, for all the hot hobby tutorials, news, rumors on all your favorite hobby topics. And head on over to thelongwar.net. That's the home of the battle reports for exclusive content, early access videos, and more. Become a veteran of the Long War today. What's up, Hobby Maniacs? Rob Bear here with another fantastic hobby tutorial on, of course, the middle of the week, the hobby hump day, the second best day of the week, depending on who you ask. Today, I'm going to show you how to paint metals with your airbrush. And metals can be a great starting point or a great, you know, accent to, you know, any project you have out there for any pretty much a broad range of hobby things, from fantasy to, you know, slash Age of Sigmar to 40k itself to, you know, the undercarriage for painting Titans, which is the same scheme that I'm going to use here on these Necrons that I'm going to show you, and also what I use for my Iron Warriors, the full-on, like, just the whole metal color for the vehicles is this recipe. Now, I also use these on my Grey Knights that I painted. If you've seen the Grey Knight tutorial on painting up 45 purifiers, this is a very similar paint scheme I used, but then I mixed in some glazes and such with blue. But today I'm going to show you, like I said, how to do this on a Necron. Now, here's the finished product right here. This little Necron guy with some OSL crazy green glow that you probably recognize from some of Kenny's tutorials there. They're also replicated based off his tutorials. You know, it's no secret I learned how to paint literally the same way a lot of you out there do, from watching Kenny's videos. I've had the chance to actually work with him in person in the same room on a lot of occasions, so that definitely helped. But I still panic call him from time to time. Oh, Kenny, oh my God, I can't make this work. What am I doing wrong, dog? But, you know, not everybody can have that kind of privilege, I guess, or mentorship, more like it. But, you know, it definitely comes in handy, I can tell you that much. But, you know, send him some messages on Facebook. He'll definitely help everybody. I saw there's actually a post on Spiky Bits that has a really interesting dialogue between him and Max at Hellfire Painting. Anywho, so what we're going to use for this today, I'm going to show you, is a Reaper Triad. Now, Reaper makes some really great paints. They're acrylic-based. I think they use liquid pigments as well, just like Privateer does. I'm not 100% on that. If they don't in these, they do in their new Bone series, which are high-density paints. Now, this is called a Triad, if you're not familiar with this particular product here, where they give you three different paints that are, you know, the base color, the highlight color, and the mid-range for a particular kind of paint. And they have, I want to say, like 40 of these things. This is the gold one that I picked up. I'm going to try this one out here in the near future, so look for a tutorial on that one. But if you want the metal one, it comes exactly the same way with all three, except for you get these colors right here. Hold on, right here. So you get black and steel, which is SKU number 09205. And then you get, because that's your base, so you're starting with the 205. And then you get 09206, which is tarnished steel, and then it kicks it up to 07, which is chromed steel, true silver. So you got true silver, tarnished steel, and blackened steel right here together to form that triad. Obviously, I mixed up one of the caps with another paint right there, but regardless, this is the metal triad that we're going to show you how to use today, and it's very similar to also Vallejo's colors out there. They have model airbrush paints as well that you can use. Now, there's black, which is just your metal black. It's not, this is a metallic black, it's not a straight black. So this is 71073, and then you've got gunmetal, which is kind of like the highlight for it. And then you can go higher than this, they make a chrome too, but a lot of times this might be plenty high for you, and this is 71072. And then the bottom, the base, is actually black itself, which I use with this tutorial too that you're gonna see. I actually come back and cut in with black to give it that nice, contrast at the very end between all of the metal. So we're gonna jump right into that here in a second, but this is basically what the finished product is going to look like, and you should see a picture of it flashing up on your screen here momentarily too. And with a little luck, next week we will have the how to do OSL with this green color tutorial for you as well. All right, so today I'm going to show you how to make metals airbrush style with this pretty sweet tutorial here using some different colors that you might not have heard of. We're going to use some Reaper game colors, and to get this really steely looking kind of feel to things, it goes a little high. I feel like you can see right here that the metal gets a little high, and I might go in and I might sponge this down a little bit, but it gets nice and bright and nice and steely, and I really like how they use their pigments in this this Reaper Master series here. So I think it's going to look great, and I think it's a great recipe. And traditionally, this is what I use for my Iron Warriors too, but I just started using one on this Necron commission here, which I think turned out pretty good with the little glow everywhere, little glow effects there. So let's take a look at the recipe here. Now, this is a Reaper Master series paint. The first one is 9205. This is black and steel. This is actually what I based a lot of the Grey Knights that I have on. Kenny painted up the Drago right here and a whole bunch of other guys. And then the tutorial I have online with not a video on how to paint is, this is the base color right here, is the 9205. And then following that is the 9206 right here, which is a little bit brighter, but not, you know, not super crazy. And then the 9207 True Silver. Now these you can purchase as a triad, they call it, from Reaper itself. I think they run about $3 or $4 each. But what I really like about these is, like I said, they got this really cool kind of different pigment. They're not the traditional kind of metal flake. You can kind of tell by the Necron Destroyer right there. And I think it looks a lot better once you spray it than some of the, you know, the metals out there on the market today, or even taking a metal that isn't designed to be airbrushed. Now Kenny's got his way, I got mine. At the end of the day, it's go with whatever works for you. You know what I mean? Like Kenny's like, I don't know why you use that stuff. And I'm like, I don't know why you use what you use, but you know what? Our stuff looks good. So, so who cares? So if you find something that you can make work, just go with it. You know what I mean? Like don't listen to Kenny, even though he thinks he knows how to airbrush dog and all that stuff. Like if you find something that works, just go with it. You know what I mean? So we're going to step right back in here in a sec with step one of how to airbrush metals. All right, so the very first part for me is I combine the primer step with the first base coat step, so I don't put a lot of wear and tear on the airbrush itself. So right here I have, well, you know, this looks very close to black and steel if you take a look, right? Like you've got this right here, and there's a pretty dark steel, and it turns out that they are very similar. They're not exact, so you know, you gotta be careful going back and doing touch-ups. This is actually the gunmetal buffing metalizer from Model Masters. Here's the part number right here, 1455. It's a ralliken, and it's a lacquer. So it, you know, a lot of people are like, yo, I don't want to use that crap on my minis, but tell you what, it actually does a really good job. So if you saw the video on priming and how to set up your projects, you're kind of already on track with how to get to this point right here. So we're not gonna cover a lot of ground on that one. We're just gonna go straight into the highlights. So first up, we're gonna do the first coat, which is actually the second highlight. We're not gonna do black and steel because, hey, black and steel, already done. We'll do our cutbacks with the black and steel so it all kind of matches at that point. But right here, we're just gonna go in and we're gonna just start laying in some highlights real quick. Checking my, make sure my pressure's good. Yep, looks like we're good here. So we're just gonna basically lightly hit up these areas that I think are, you know, that I think would naturally be highlighted, right? Now remember too, you're gonna come in with another highlight, so that'll be like towards the bottom right there, I feel like. So I'm just gonna basically go through, hit all the areas that I think would naturally have some sort of highlights. Like this right here, on the thrusters, around the front, you know, on this raised spot right here, like the ridges. Now we're gonna come in and hit that vent with some black and stuff. Now this little spine right here is a little tricky. but I want it to be lighter. So we're gonna get in there, we're gonna get it, we're gonna make it happen. And then all around the world right here, just gently kind of fading up towards the flat part. I'm gonna switch it around, get in here and do it on this side. Sometimes it's good to have like a little flight stand or something to hold on to, because it's very difficult sometimes to not mess up your fresh paint with your fingers. But we'll be okay. And I'm gonna cut across on the spine right here. Now what's really cool about this, if you look at the, if you kind of take a mental image of the one I showed you, like the finished product, there's a lot of glow effects and there's a lot of cutbacks and fades and contrasts in black to the actual green. So we're not gonna get too crazy, and even if we get too crazy with the highlights here, we can always cut it back. And we're gonna do gold on the shoulder pads, so I don't really need to worry about if I overspray on that. The one thing I was a little sad about, I feel like I didn't get the chest bright enough on that one I did already, so I'm gonna make sure I get in there good on this one. Nice and bright chest right there. We're gonna hit the head, because the head's where everybody always looks. You wanna make sure you get a good fade on that. I'm gonna check our weapon over here. Of course, the weapon tips are gonna be faded, so I wanna make sure we get all that nice and good. And cut back right here, underneath here. Now a lot of people are like, hey, why didn't you get the top of the hand? But fortunately, we might get a little bit of glow on that hand too. I don't know, with the thing raised in the air though, but maybe not. So we wanna make sure we do a good job highlighting this hand. Like right here at the edge of the fingers, little spot right there. And if we look down, we wanna make sure we got everything highlighted up pretty good. Get this spine. Get in there and get kind of lateral on the spine so we get a good angle of attack on it. Back on this side. Boom, super easy. Now in here on this gun too, we wanna make sure we get a good fade on that one, right? So I feel like we're gonna hit right here, cause I know there's gonna be a lot of greens, but I still wanna make sure that we try to represent as best we can on this one. Wanna make sure we get nice good contrast on the end of the barrel right there. We'll get in here. Now, because it's a black base coat, sort of, it's kind of more of a gunmetal, the color's gonna fade. So I'm gonna go back and hit it with a second coat real quick, just very lightly from a distance here. Get in all the spots I need. Man, that spine's looking good. This front's looking good. The next color, the next highlight actually, is really gonna pop it. So I just wanna make sure I have enough contrast with this color here. And I really think we do. So you can kind of see right there, you still got your areas back here where it's a little shaded. It's hard to see everything at this point because it is, just a metal color. But once we start adding more highlights, it's gonna be a lot easier to see, I feel like. So we'll be back hitting that one up, give it a little bit. See right there, you can see some of the contrast. So it'll start to pop here with the next highlight, I swear. And next up in the series is the Reaper True Silver. That's the 207 color. That's gonna really start to make this stuff pop and make us definitely think about doing some cutbacks. So I got my reservoir all filled up right there, ready to go. Looking good on the spray. So we will try our first victim here, the guy from a few minutes ago. There you can kind of see some of his highlights popping out, but we're gonna probably overshadow those a little bit with this really bright color. And what I noticed too is sometimes it's fun just to hit the bottom, just to kind of see if your mix is going well before, so you don't accidentally ruin anything that's like noticeable, you know. So we're gonna start down here, just get a gauge for how bright this really is, and woo, there it is right there, right? Pretty bright. But I like it because it's nice and smooth. It's a smooth, consistent steel color that I feel is really good. I mean, look at that right there. Like, that's really, really working through. So we're just gonna hit all the spots that we hit before, but just a little bit tighter towards the tips, like right here. You know, we're just gonna hit right towards the top, start to make that pop. all that right there. Now the gun's really starting to pop. We're going to hit the top of the head right here. Some more the spine coming down the back. But we're going to be a little bit more careful. I'm going to get in there. I'm going to be more directful with the spray. So it's not too crazy. There you can see you got the delineation across the spine back here. We're going to be a little bit more careful right there. This ridge. And we're going to cut it back around. Really trying to aim towards the edge of the model itself. You can start to see that fade right there starting to form. We're going to get just the edges of the air vents right there just to get that nice fade. You can see it from the top down view really starting to form. Go around the world right here. Back up the track. And hit some of these arms, kind of like the hands, the very tips, the fingers, some of that right there. Look at the front here, see what we got going on. So we definitely need to hit, let's see what we got. We're definitely gonna hit the face, right towards, I'm aiming towards the nose, so it kind of radiates out, you can see it right there. And then I'm gonna try to get right in a cut here, right almost to the armpits. Because I know when I put the black in there to do the cutbacks, it's going to overpower some of that. So I want to make sure I go super bright with the first pass. And then the hips right here. Looks like we got a blockage. There we go. Right around there. There it goes. All right. Sometimes you just got to work your paints while they're in the pot right there, and because they start to clog things up. Now, I listen to Kenny, of course, a lot, and I do use this Airbrush Flow Improver, which is a big help, to be quite honest. But you can see here, it's definitely starting to clog up. So you can always take like a little stick and just be like, yo, let me get in here, see what's going on, get a good mix. This is the old whippy stick that used to come with the starters. So you can get in there, you can do it that way. Or if you have a Buster brush, something that you mind don't getting thrashed, like this old GW paintbrush from like way, way, way back in the day, I'm going to get in there. I know those bristles are getting down in the reservoir, and just try to make sure we get it all stirred up right here. And then we're going to give it a good... blow it back, give it a good college try, open it up, full throttle. And it looks like it's back on track, so I'm going to wipe off my hand there for a second. And go get the next color. Alright, next up is going to be that dark, dark black and steel color here. To do some cutbacks with. I got it all mixed up in my pot already, looking good. It's a little watery, but it's not too crazy. I feel like I can work with it. So this is a good test for the, hey, spray the underneath real quick, just in case you got any bugs, right? Now you can see it's coming out a little watery, but it's not too bad. It's good. It's good for kind of like a little fake wet blend right there. You can kind of see, now that's, you can do the trick where you can just basically push them down on the air to kind of dry it out, and you can see it's getting that nice fade there. Now it's a lot of steel, and there's still not a lot of contrast, I feel like, in this. So we're gonna hit it with black after we're done with this, just to get some really, really nice contrast with it. I'm sure a lot of it is gonna get overshadowed with the glow effects, like we saw with the demo model there. But I still wanna get that contrast in there. So you can see I'm kind of hitting all the different spots. I'm going to go in here on tight on the chest area. I'm going to get the underarms. And then I'm going to get up here in this rib cage, kind of down here in the crotch region, cutting across, getting in some of them joints right there. We're going to go lateral on this thing, take a look at it. I'm going to try to get up in that spine right there. I'm not sure if I can, but I'm gonna try it. It seems okay. We're gonna hit that with some black too and see what happens. And then right here on this big flat area, I'm just gonna get in there. I'm just gonna hit it. I'm just gonna lay it all out. You can see the transition between it, but like I said, it still doesn't have that really great popping contrast that I want in my model. So I'm gonna hit this over here, blend it all together. Blend it back in there, getting this spine area right there. And I feel like for the most part that's good. I'm gonna get right here on the elbow joint. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. So I think when you see the last step in this whole steel process here of the black, you're really gonna see some popping happen right there. So this is the time that in the project where everything seems to come together all at once. This is gonna be the most amount of contrast we're gonna see. And of course, it's probably gonna make this pop. Or at least that's the intention, I hope. So what's really cool is a lot of times you have to go back and refade a lot of things. But because we went back and did that dark metal at the very end, as our first cutback, then the black, if we apply it very, very subtly and very liberally, it should just, unless, you know, barring a major screw up, it should just work. Like, I really feel confident about this. I swear, we're gonna make it work. So we're gonna start underneath, because that seems to be a good place to start in case bad things happen. At least we didn't screw up the front. And we're just gonna get in here with this black. It's just a normal airbrush black. I think it's the Minichair line, but I mean, you can use anything. You can use Vallejo, whatever. It's all good. Of course, I was talking so long, it started to get weird in the pot there. So I gotta be a little bit more careful, but you kind of get the idea there now that we're starting to see the contrast. So it almost looks like that itself was a dark steel, but it was really a black. It's just kind of applied over that metal. And you can kind of see there, as I start to apply the transitions, you can really start to see that contrast I was talking about. Now we're gonna flip up to here and try not to screw anything up here. We're gonna hit this little edge here that I've been working, and then bring it up into the bridge right here. Little groin area there, get some nice shade. Now I really want these ribs, these little holes in these ribs, so I'm gonna try to carefully get in here and get those. Very carefully, very subtly, but it looks like we did it. And then I'm gonna get these underarms, kind of reverse shade it back into there. A lot of this is gonna get covered up with some green glow, but you know, I feel like at the end of the day, it's all good. And get that hand underneath that elbow joint. Make sure you got the flow coming. Now I want to reverse hit this tip here to make it really nice. So we're going to this back area here, reverse to really fade that up nice too. So there you can kind of see all that, right? So now we get to this side here, and I want to get in here and give this spine some contrast. Woo! There it is. That worked out good. Get this other one. Loving it. Get this elbow gap. Some transition on the knuckles here. That looks alright. I'm not happy with it, but we'll keep it. It's a keeper. And then we're gonna start getting kind of crazy, because that'll definitely get covered up. Now we got a lot of space here, a lot of wide open places, so much room for activity. So I want to be very gentle the first pass here. I don't want to screw anything up, but I want it to try to, you know, transition very well. So I'm going to get a lot in here on this grill. And that looks good. And now we're going to bring it back. Nice and subtle. Nice and subtle strokes right there. I'm getting that dark metal look. flip it over, do the other side. Kind of give you a good look there. Hit that grill good. Pull it back nice and steady. Get a nice little fade to the back. That don't look too bad. That looks like some darkened metal, something you expect to see with some washers or something like that. But really, it was just some subtle airbrush highlights, a little atmospheric high-speed streaking almost, I feel like, but still looks really good. I kind of want to get in here in this spine area. It doesn't look like there's a lot of transition in there, so I'm going to try to carefully get in there. Looks like I did okay. I think that might be one of those spots where I would hit it. If I came back with a brighter color, I would hit right across there at the top. I'm not sure if I'm going to yet. But if I make enough mistakes, I might have to, right? All right, so now, this was an area right here that I wanted to get a lot of transition in that I don't feel like I did with the demo model. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna focus on these little ports sticking up. Now that looks good. I'm happy with that because it's got a nice big transition that works its way right around those little ports. Do the same thing over here. And that is looking good. So now I feel like we have successfully shaded our steel. Let's take a look. So here's our guy. Pretty well shaded. I didn't really mess with the face because I know that green glow is gonna take over a lot of it. Same with this tubing, all this stuff down in here. You know, a lot of this over here is gonna get taken over, but I feel like if you look at it, it's nice and shaded. Even the underneath, like if somebody picks this up, you know, to be a dick bag, or, you know, if you just have it on your flight stand, you know, you might actually see the underneath. The underneath is shaded too, so, you know, bonus points. And also that helps you test your airbrush flow and not screw up your front, because you don't want to be screwing this up. So I feel like that's a nice solid transition. That's exactly where I would start working in some of these greens and doing some of these metals. And really working that transition there. You can see it's almost identical, but just I didn't get those ports right here. I actually might go in and hit that right now with it. Well, I gotta be careful because of that green. I actually can't. So it's just gonna be one of those things that I didn't quite get to on one of the models here. Now the light's pretty bright in here and you can't really see, the green kind of looks forced, but I assure you it is very transition-y and it actually looks better than it does in this video, at least looking through this little viewfinder here. So that is how to shade metal. You can apply this to, you know, rhinos, all sorts of different things, you know, tanks, dudes, Mechanicus guys, you know, and then you come back and do your other colors over top of it, like your red robes with Mechanicus, or in this case, I'm gonna get green. Now, a lot of people, that's a really bright green. A lot of people wouldn't agree with it, but at the end of the day, you're working with metal, okay? Like, you look at a table full of this, you can't tell from 5 feet away if this is painted good or not. Not until you pick it up. But nobody's going to actually sit there and pick it up unless they're like, oh my gosh, what is that? What is that green all about? Let me pick up that green. So by putting that green in there, it really, not only does it make it pop, but it draws interest to the model itself. And then once people pick it up, they're like, wow, that green's awesome. Oh dang, your metals are tight too. Like, how did you do that? You know, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, while it might not be the most realistic color and it might be a little a little bright, a little shiny, a little peacocky, so to speak, I feel like at the end of the day, your stuff will definitely get noticed if you start, you know, using some of these greens here that Kenny loves so much, or even some of the purples that he does. I haven't dabbled in the purples, but I definitely feel like I got the greens on lock right here. So that's it for this one, folks. I hope you enjoyed how to airbrush metals.
Deleted scenes, bonus content, and all the interviews and post-game wrap-up videos can be located in the Hall of Veterans on thelongwar.net. Visit thelongwar.net today and try a week completely free with no strings attached. That's not all. Thelongwar.net is also your hobby resource for exclusive early access with an ad-free experience to all your favorite videos. Members of the Hall of Veterans gain early exclusive access to multiple hobby videos.